said a fucking mouthful, 3D. And speaking of holy, here he is, right here. The man himself, Holy Trent Acid.
Making his way upstairs, presumably from the bowels of hell, holding what appears to be a Bible stolen from the Comfort Inn, Guido.
Well, hey, what can you do? He's climbing the gates of heaven, but he's got a stolen Bible from the Comfort Inn. But that's not all he's got to worry about right now. What he has to worry about right now is the Japanese juggalo sensation, Nozawa.
Nozawa squaring up against Trent Acid one-on-one. Let's get down to the ring for some JCW. This match is a 10-minute time limit match. Introducing first, from the Vatican in South Philadelphia, weighing in at 49 stones, please welcome Holy Trent Acid!
There he is!
Complete with his 45-minute long intro, thus we took the liberties, wisely enough, to shorten his intro down to a mere only 17 minutes.
Well, 3D, who the fuck would? I mean, I don't want to sit through 45 minutes of bullshit. He's blessing the crowd, he's blessing me, he's blessing you, and he can fuck off.
He likes to christen them with the holy water, he likes to bless the people, and he likes to molest the children.
Well,
he is holy and full of holes.
Well, hey, the only hole he has is in his asshole right now. This man coming up next is going to come put a new hole next to his asshole between the butt cheeks.
There, Juggalo showing their appreciation for Trent Acid.
And his opponent from Osaka, Japan, weighing 89 kilos, the Japanese Juggalo sensation, Nozawa!
And there he goes, 3D. There he fucking goes.
No stranger to JCW at all, Nozawa. Right there with the hatchet man on his neck. Nozawa is a former JCW World Heavyweight Champion.
That's right, 3D. He held that belt for 1 year and 2 months. 14 months for all you fucking assholes out there.
He held the belt proudly and defended it on his many travels. This man frequents Mexico. This man frequents the Orient. And of course...
Hey, knock that shit off! No! He said knock it off, 3D. You better shut up.
He's got the stick. Hey. As if his intro wasn't long enough. How about some fucking wasted mic time from the holy asshole?
You call it a stick, I call it a dick.
This should be short and sweet, Guido.
Yeah. An hour and a half long, short and sweet.
JCW, I am your new holy leader. I am Trent Acid, and I am here to save you.
Save us from jail time and penitentiary time from pedophiling little kids, little boys.
Now, it has been brought to my attention that a lot of juggalos and juggalettes like to think they're tough.
Juggalos letting them know what the fuck they think of his punk ass. I agree, 3D.
Now, you want to know what's tough? What's tough is coming out here and not puking when I look at your stupid painted faces.
Cheap heat always works.
Oh, is it ever cheap and is it ever heat? He says, hold on. Hold your tongues.
Hold on. He's got more cheap heat for you.
He's got cheap heat for days. He likes the bent down ass up position.
You know, I can't respect a bunch of people that follow two guys that paint their faces like clowns.
Wow, cheap heaterama, 3D. Cheap heaterama.
It don't get much cheaper than that, Guido.
Besides that cheap ass dress he's got on. I believe they're talking about Cheap J Strongbow.
Now, maybe you people should do something smart and follow me instead of living your lives like a bunch of eat-up, fat, smelly potheads.
Maybe he should do something smart and worry about Nozawa before Nozawa throws a shiny wizard and knocks his fucking melon clean off his neck, Guido.
He could throw a shiny wizard at Trent Acid, shiny wizard. Whoa, the one finger salute. Nozawa's ready for this fuckhead. He's ready to kick his throat in through his asshole.
Nozawa is no stranger to what's happening here. What's happening here is mind games on behalf of Trent Acid. Quite simply put, fucking mind games. The whole talking shit on the mic, the whole two-hour entrance, the whole having the ref peel off his dress.
But, 3D, you must remember, Nozawa is no stranger to the squared circle. He's been in this ring since he can roll over on his stomach, since he can walk upright, since he can do a moonsault off the top rope. He's no stranger to the shit talking. He's no stranger to the squared circle whatsoever. And I think he has the tools to take what it is ready to take this fucking man, Holy Trent Acid, through the tarp, through the canvas, through the wood planks and metal, straight to hell where he belongs.
Well, not only is he no stranger to the ring, he happens to be a master of the ring, trained by his coach, by his mentor, his teacher, the great Muda himself.
And right there you said a mouthful. Listen to him. Get in the crowd pumped. Get the JCW chant pumped. Because he knows Trent Acid plays mind games. He's playing them right back towards that fuckhead himself.
That's right. This is not a This is not a one-on-one match, obviously. This is more like Trent Acid versus Nozawa and 1,500 faithful juggalos.
Not to mention the spirit of Muda. He's not even dead. He's marinating in Japan, looking over Nozawa as we speak.
And his spirit is so strong, it's right there with Nozawa.
And his spirit's so strong, you've seen Holy Trent Acid get a bottle upside his fucking nugget. And fully sold it to the fullest. And I believe they're not calling Nozawa a pussy.
No, I don't think so either.
I think they're calling what they see under fucking Holy Trent Acid's nutsack a pussy. Get off them ropes, you cocksucker. Get up there, Nozawa. Get your proper dues. Look at, he got pissed like a baby woman, kicked the rope like a little baby girl.
Trent Acid is gonna do whatever it takes to stall this out, to take his time to avoid what's coming, and that's an ass whipping.
Of course he is, because he is not a physical athlete like Nozawa is. He likes to play the mind games like you said, 3D.
Don't get me wrong. He's a dangerous man, but his talent, there you go. One for you, Trent.
One for the road, you fucking asshole.
Sit and spin, homo.
But you see the mind games he's playing. He's extending a hand in friendship. Nobody wants to be your friend, you fucking pedophiler. Nozawa's going for it. What are you doing, Nozawa?
Watch it, Nozawa. He's a sneaky bastard.
Where could he went? It's so small. Where'd he go? What the fuck? Oh, Pearl Harbor. Jeez, old Pete. And look at him. He's loving it. He's fucking loving it.
Well, Acid's a dirty bastard. As I was saying before, he's a dangerous wrestler because he relies on shitty-ass, dirty tactics.
And choking people. What the fuck is this? It's not
and humping their neck. Look at that.
JCW or not, no legalness to that choke whatsoever. That fucking dick, he's getting me pissed off. And look, he's getting pissed off. The Juggalos are pumping me up. I hope they do the same for Nozawa.
Nozawa is a competitor known for 10-star matches.
And
look at this.
There you go. You see it going down right now. Oh, the baseball son. Ow!
Lightning speed. Lightning speed kicks.
Oh!
Right there. Swift boot to the side of the earlobe.
And right to that top rope to get the crowd approval. Now, Holy Trent Acid will need metal rods in that knee after that fucking drop kick. One drop kick by Nozawa can end your fucking career, 3D.
What style do you want to take to Nozawa? He's done it before. He's mastered all styles. Do you want to bring a lucha style? Do you want to bring a Japan style?
Or a fucking Roddy Piper eye poke style? There it goes.
He's got them all down, and he's ready for battle. Trent Acid shoulder tackle. Lightning speed over him once again. Under the legs. And right there. Super kick to the chin of the asshole.
There you go. He's lucky he didn't kick him in the asshole with that kick.
Shades
of him, his asshole would have been hanging out the end of his dick hole.
Shades of Great Muda once again. We're seeing his mentor shining through Nozawa.
Of course you are, because Nozawa is Muda's star pupil. And look at him. He's going to throw him into the turnbuckles and finish him off right. Oh, what is this dastardly deeds? This motherfucker. You know what?
Ooh.
Oh, he gave him a taste of his own medicine and made fun out of him on top of it. What a fucking cocksucker. Let me tell you something about this guy, Trent Acid. I don't like him. Straight up, I don't like him. I'm not a heel. I'm a face. And I'm not a fan of this fucking guy humping men.
Well, not many people do like him, Guido. But he is no joke in a squared circle. And his win-loss record cannot be disputed. And his talents cannot be denied.
You're right. It can't be denied. It can't be disputed. But nonetheless, I think you like his humping techniques. And I don't like you for liking him. Look at this shit right here. He's standing up on the rope. Even JCW has standards of cheating, 3D. And right there is blatant fucking choking on that bottom rope. And I'm getting bloody fucking pissed off about this shit.
Fucking chill your balls off. Because I'm confident Nozawa will handle this problem by bell's end.
I don't know what the fuck bell's end are.
Bell's end means by the time the motherfucking bell rings.
Well, good. Bell's end. Ball's end. Ball's hanging. All I know is Trent Acid is letting his balls hang in Nozawa's face right now. And I'm not digging what the fuck I'm seeing. I know he's used to little boys, but this is a fucking grown man, damn it. And look at that. Blatant disrespect by grabbing him up, picking him up, slamming him down. And what the fuck? He's blessing him.
Notice,
he don't need blessing. He's a Buddhism.
Notice how Trent Acid likes to bless his opponents. Only you got to notice Nozawa is always aware of his positioning.
Holy
thus,
ever.
Trent Acid was just blessed face first by the canvas.
You're fucking right. And you are right. Nozawa knows his way around that ring. And he knew Trent Acid was coming onto the canvas. And he fucking moved just in time for Trent Acid.
There it is! The Shining Wizard right there. Talk to him by the one and only Great Muda.
This might be it right here, 3D. I think we're talking 1, 2, 3. But Nozawa's stalling. He's not doing the pin. He's not picking the leg up. Oh, but he ducks.
He's very rarely do you see Nozawa make those kind of mistakes.
Let me tell you
very rarely
right
do you see Nozawa be overtaken by the Juggalo audience and actually slip and not go for a pin like that.
But, 3D, right now, Trent Acid is at the disadvantage. He's outside the ring. Outside the ring is 10 times more deadly than inside the ring.
Have a
Look
seat.
At that. Oh, shit. Have a seat. A hot steamer on your face. That outside the ring right there is full of debris. It's full of garbage. It's full of metal chunks. It's full of auto car parts. It doesn't matter what the fuck goes down. Shit is going down outside the rings where the rules are out the fucking window. And look it. He's bringing outside of the ring to the inside of the ring. Nozawa is not fucking playing. He's bringing these JCW rules to his advantage inside the ring as well as outside the ring.
The capacity crowd, without a doubt, behind their hero Nozawa. But once again, Trent Acid could give a fuck less about the people, only concerned about dirty tactics and whatever it's going to take to pin this man to the mat.
With the hurricane crossface deed. One, two. Oh.
No good.
Three, you could have been more right. I think Nozawa could have pinned him two or three times more. But he's concerned with the Juggalo chance and the Juggalo approval. As to where Trent Acid don't give a fuck about that. He's carrying on his ruthless assault left and right. But yet he has not won for a pin himself.
Trent Acid, having competed all over the North Coast, all over the East Coast, all over the Northeast, and the Eastern North Coast.
Well, 3D, the North Coast would be the fucking Antarctic up there on the North Pole where Santa Claus lives. And I think maybe he started a missionary up there and had all the elves gathered around him and pedophile him. But that does not matter right now. Right now, Nozawa is face down on that chair, ready for his chin to go. Oh!
Once again, Nozawa, no stranger, very aware of where his opponent is at all time, kicks the top rope, causing Trent to fall and split his pussy wide open on that steel rack.
And that now goes back to that ring experience with the superplex to add insult to injury through the motherfucking chair.
Awesome.
Holy shit.
Going for the pin.
One, two. Oh! See, right there, Trent Acid, not giving a fuck about crowd approval. That is why he kicked up. The only reason, and on top of that, Nozawa did not hook the fucking leg. If he would have hooked that leg, he would have had him. I believe so. You believe so.
I believe the referee's arms were too long and lanky, causing too much time before the hand slapped on the mat. And it was a slow count.
It didn't stop that long leg from kicking him in the fucking... Oh!
Oh!
And what is
get
this?
Out of the way!
Oh!
Right there.
Two, three, oh!
Damn it!
I believe that
damn
Holy
it.
Bible is a satanic Bible with the Holy Bible cover on it. There's no way a Holy Bible would have done that. But we must remember that the Japanese Juggalo Cessation is a Buddhist.
I can't believe it.
Holy Trent!
And all we can say that
asshole
is holy shit, Trent Asshole.
He used the good book for an evil purpose, and he gained the victory.
You know, 3D, oh, there it goes, right there, the dragon kick. Maybe it should be called the bad book. I don't know what to think. My brain is turned into mush, oatmeal, if you will. Perhaps grits with extra butter and sugar.
It was a great match. There it is, Lucifer's Loop. It looked bad for Nozawa. And there, superplex onto the chair. It looked good for Nozawa. But you know what? Asshole Trent Acid could not pin Nozawa until he used foul tactics. In wrestling alone, Guido, in wrestling alone, Trent Acid could not defeat Nozawa.
No, he couldn't.
He needed to use the crooked good book for evil purposes. Thus, he gained the victory. Bullshit, I say. Bullshit.
What I say is fuck Holy Trent Acid. That's how to be. Juggalos and wrestling fans, I'm here right now with Nozawa. Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
And hello, Trent Acid.
Hi.
Hello, Brother Guido.
Now, we have some totally shit going down right here, in which a week ago, Nozawa was cheated by Trent Acid and his holy of holiest Bible, which is full of holes. Nozawa, please, if you will.
Shaggy-san, koitsu wa senshu kono hon de ore no koto nagutta nda yo. Konna kachikata aru kara ore no hou ga ii wrestler ni kimatte nda ro. Wakarimasu? Daijoubu? Onegaishimasu.
Ik sneak sunshi.
Hai.
Hai. Now, Trent Acid, last week, your whole game was full of shit. Nozawa, next week in Minneapolis, he says he's gonna whip your ass fair and square. Your words.
Brother Guido, I don't speak fluent Japanese, but I don't believe he said that.
Hasol, huka, humba, ha, ho.
Well, in that in mind, I'm a man of the Lord, and I'm here on a mission. And I'm a man of second chances. As you know, the Lord has given us the gift of life. And in return, JCW, Nozawa, Shaggy-san, Brother Guido, I will give you that second chance next week. I accept your challenge in the good faith of the Lord.
Whoa! Holy shit!
What the fuck?
Konnichiwa!
Wakaranai!
Hakasu!
What a match that's gonna be next week! Nozawa in the rematch against Holy Trent Acid! But right now, I'm being told something's going on in the back!
Hey! I just caught up. What's going on, 3D? What's going on in here?
Look at that, Tracy Smothers! It's choking somebody again! Holy fuck!
He's gonna kill him! He said it himself, he's gonna kill him! We got another pig! Call the police, goddammit! What the fuck is he doing?
Get him off that guy!
Look at those young-ass blue shorts! What the fuck? He's choking people with young shorts on! Not right, goddammit! Not right!
And who the fuck is that?
He's just some innocent bystander getting choked!
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable indeed.
That man is truly crazy. But let's get down to the main event. Holy Trent Acid one-on-one against the Flaming Fist, Too Tough Tony. Woo-hoo.
Coming to the ring at this time, he is from the Vatican in South Philadelphia. He weighs in at an astonishing 47 stones. Accompanied to the ring by the good book. Please welcome Holy Trent Acid.
Fuck him!
Hey, he's full of holes, including the one in his ass. That's the biggest hole he has on his body.
Holy Trent Acid with long ass intro included.
Well, speaking of holy, his hole is full of shit, just like him. And look at him squabbling with juggalettes. What kind of fucking coward it squabbles with women? That fucking bastard.
Trent Acid taking his sweet time as fucking usual.
That's right. Everybody sit down, have a smoke, have a drink. Do whatever you gotta do to stall a little bit of time, because this fucker is officially here, and boy, oh boy, does he like to milk the clock.
Go to the crapper and drop the kids off at the pool if you gotta. Now's the time.
Sure, go to the mall, buy a couple shirts, take the car through the wash. Trent Acid is on his way to the fucking ring.
Go on out to the car and rub one out if you're horny. You got time.
Or if you're holy, like this pedophile right here.
Or if you're a horny, holy bitch like Trent Acid, you might as well commit some pedophile-atry.
Well, it's about fucking time, because he's about to get a mud hole stomped in his ass. And when I say mud hole, I mean a Louisville, Kentucky mud hole. What's going on here? Oh, 3D with the one-finger salute once again. Oh!
And his opponent, from Louisville, Kentucky, accompanied to the ring by some extra strong liquor.
As always, 3D.
Please welcome Too Tough Tony.
Guido, I'll tell you this much about Tony. He is quickly becoming a Juggalo favorite.
Well, fuck that. He's always swinging off that fifth and letting the underage Juggalos enjoy it ringside as he enjoys it.
Well, that's
in the barricades.
That's one thing I really enjoy about Tony's entrance.
Hey, he shares.
It's nothing sweeter than seeing him pour liquor into underage children's mouths.
Well, what do you want? He's from Louisville, Kentucky. They start early there. It's summer, much like him, but a Southern favorite.
They sure do start early. They have babies when they're only 11.
Why? That's enough, you motherfucker. Because we're talking about Too Tough Tony here. He's a full-grown man handling full-grown business in the square circle of JCW against this cocksucker, Trent Acid.
Well, he's a full-grown man handling full-grown business, and he's got a bottle of grown man with him.
That's right. And he'll put that and swing it down. He'll swing it down to his throat and blow it in your face and catch it on fire like that mannequin for a referee in the ring. He looks like he has a fucking standard stick up his asshole.
Now there's the epitome of health.
Yes, if you like to eat berries and fucking leaves, that's how you'll turn out.
Too Tough Tony ready to get this motherfucking match started.
And look at him, he's pointing to the juice. He don't even call it liquor, he calls it juice.
He calls it sauce.
Hey, look, there goes the epitome of health. A fucking cigarette and a bottle of liquor. Fuck that referee's skinny, healthy ass. It's all about the Louisville, Kentucky diet. Fuck the South Beach diet.
That's Tony's entire training regimen. Well, left hand, bottle of liquor. Right hand, three cigarettes.
And as you can see, it looks like he's smuggling four midgets under his t-shirt. That's because of all the liquor and cigarettes.
Don't worry about that, Guido. Worry about the damage he's about to inflict on Trent Acid's chin.
Hey, and look, he's like, fuck you, security. Give me a pitcher of fucking beer to taste the liquor down with. Hey, and if you're not quick with it, I'll bust you in the head with it when I'm done. Do I care about it dripping down my lip? No. Look at him go. Look, oh, he's taking a cap off. Look at that. Holy shit. Look, that's the Louisville diet. Fuck the South Beach. I'm going on the Louisville diet, and I'm going to turn loopy, but nonetheless, I'll have a fish that burns faces.
I've been on the Louisville diet for the past 3 years, and look at me.
Yes.
I'm in prime physical condition.
You look just like that referee, 3D. And look at this fuckhead. He always wants to pimp the referees. This referee, however, I guess he is having it, but not as much as the other one. At least he's not sucking his dick. Look, Trent Acid probably would want.
Say what you want about Trent Acid, but he's got an undefeated streak going on of one win and zero losses.
That's right. And look at, he's giving him a hug on the head.
He baptized the little boy.
Well, hey, he might baptize Tony's nuts with his foot because it's going to fuck down. Like I keep saying, like him or hate him, Trent Acid is a man to put your money on because in that squared circle, he is very tricky. He is very swift. No, he's not the strongest man in JCW, but he does have the tricks to get it done.
The Juggalos of Grand Rapids appreciating the presence of Too Tough as he gets ready to lock horns with the devil himself, Trent Asshole.
Hey, the devil always wins, you motherfucker. That's why Trent Acid always wins. And by the way, speaking of the devil, what is Tony pouring down his face? The devil. Go ahead and argue me that one. The only one in that ring that is not the devil is that skinny referee. And clearly ICP is not in the ring, but Tony is representing, I believe. He's taking the blessing. Ow! And rejecting the blessing from this unforsaken man.
When push comes to shove, Too Tough Tony is the crowd favorite.
That's right, because he pushes and fucking shoves, and your ass will hit that floor when he does either one. Now look at the begging and pleading. Like I said, he's tricky. He's smart with the fucking mouthpiece. Ow! Once again, oh, it was so hard we showed it three fucking times.
Major back bumps on behalf of Holy Trent.
I'll clue you in on something too, 3D, if I may.
Please!
That fucking mat is hard. It's made out of wood and steel. None of this soft fucking cotton bullshit you used to see it on your local TV channels. Fuck no. I took one bump in there and I retired. It's hard. Like maybe the dick of Holy Trent Acid. Oh, you fucking boo.
Get the match started already for crying out loud.
Well, that's one thing the sneaky fuck depends upon is the response of the crowd. And look, he's welcoming Tony up there. But look. A whole different response, 3D. A whole different response. These Juggalos liking Too Tough Tony, not liking the brainwashing ways of this fucking unholy Trent fucking dickhead.
Whatever. If you ask me, they're both bullshitting and pussyfooting. I say lock up and let's have a wrestling match.
Well, I say the same thing, but that fucking mat hurts. And they both know it. I would be pussyfooting too. Oh, and look at the goober on his fucking chest.
Somebody hocked a loogie right at him.
That makes me want to puke looking at it. It was the nastiest thing I've seen all night. Oh, there they go.
The overwhelming, astounding fuck you chant goes out to Trent Acid for bullshitting and pussyfooting.
Showing the true appreciation of the holiest of holy men here in the JCW. Look, Tony going up to get his props again.
Well, he needs a pop before he does any move. Hey!
Oh!
Here's a pop to your spine.
That's right. He needs all the pops he can get to chase down that liquor with. But right now, he's getting number boots upside the back and back of the fucking head. Holy shit. He got what you call a stomping. Down into the fucking pavement. It's not even pavement, but it feels like it. And there he goes, Trent Acid. That fucker always choking people and shit. Fuck you, Trent.
Trent Acid applying the gum-laced boot to the neck of Too Tough Tony.
You know what? This Trent Acid and me one day are going to tangle because his tactics are starting to piss me off. This big sneaky sidewinder. And he screams like a woman on top of it.
He screams like a woman because...
Wow.
Tony firing back with those big right hands.
Let me tell you something, 3D. Them are not wrestling punches. Tony's fingers are like full-boiled sausages. And when they hit your chin, you fucking know about it.
Well, of course, anybody that's ever shook the hand of Too Tough Tony knows that his fingers are like kielbasa sticks.
That's right. Shaking the hand of Too Tough Tony is like grabbing a bunch of fucking bananas.
His hand is like a catcher's mitt.
That's right.
He's got a hand with five hard dicks on it.
Oh, shit. It's like he stuck his hand into a bubbling hot fire for 4 days straight, pulled it out, peeled the skin off, and threw Trent Acid right over the fucking top rope after he shook his hand with his hard dicks.
Tony, nothing new to hardcore outside of the ring death matches. And look at that kid's hair in the crowd.
Holy shit, he's got a plant on his head.
What the fuck's going on?
He's balancing a fucking fern on top of his head. He got it from the jungles of Uganda.
Tony now?
He's getting petted.
Being petted protrusiously by the juggalos.
Whoa, only here in JCW you can see a wrestler get petted and at the same time see a man balancing a fern on top of his head. What the fuck is going on? And he's outside in a deadly, fucking flivorous, fucking viper pit that we call outside the ring.
Into the guardrail.
No budge. He got spewed on. Right
up
there.
Up and over. Into the crowd goes Holy Trent Acid.
Look at, he's getting stopped by juggalos. Right there is the most dangerous place. Dangerous place that Holy Trent Acid can be in this whole building, 3D, is out there with the juggalos because they hate him with a fucking passion.
Well, he's got a choice to make. In the ring, he's got one tough-ass opponent. Over the guardrail, he's got 1,200 tough-ass opponents.
Well, at least he's got one tickler and one fern head that he's going to deal with out there. But nonetheless, he's still got Too Tough Tony staring him right down the fucking face piece. And then again with the sausages, right upside the nugget. Look at Tony's happy about it. He loves being out there. Look at him. He's high-fiving juggalos like Teen Wolf. Holy fuck. He's loving it.
Trent Acid now in the ring nursing that hurt knee.
Ow! And the bottle from the juggalos prevails. You know what? I think Trent Acid takes more bumps from the juggalos than he does his competitors, 3D.
Well, they're constantly throwing heavy shit at his head.
That's right. Heavy artillery to his gay head. Oh, what's he doing? He's going back outside to the dangerous jungles of Fernhead.
Where'd he go? He disappeared up in smoke again.
You seen it do it once. Perhaps he did it again. Now he disappeared for good.
With the unholy powers of Satan, Trent Acid has disappeared
and reappeared with a chair.
On the other side of the ring. Uh-oh, Tony.
Oh! Out there you want, 3D. Those chairs in the back are the worst kind of chair bumps you can take because they really fucking hurt.
And you don't see them coming, and neither does your spine.
Ho, ho, ho. Good thing Tony's spine is covered with layers of flab. Otherwise, he'd be hurting more than he is. There goes our turnbuckle, Cam, and there goes the holy blessing to it. And he's going to the top of that turnbuckle.
Trent Acid climbing the top rope. Off the rope with a reverse splash.
That was a reverse ass. And, oh, only a two count. I thought for sure he'd have a three count. See, that's when I say Shree, it means I think for sure he's gonna have a three.
I think Tony's still feeling the effects of that chair. And now the chair is back in the presence of Acid.
And you know what? Even though he did that reverse splash, you see Holy Trent Acid still feeling the effects of that dangerous maneuver on his leg as he's limping. And what the fuck is he doing now, 3D?
Doesn't look good. Doesn't look like it's gonna work.
That didn't look good. That was a real punch to the dick.
Could this be a Tony driver?
Oh! No, a reversal. One.
Oh!
I heard it.
Standing drop kick.
Holy
pie
shit.
Face.
I heard the spit in his cheeks. Wow, that had to hurt. I heard it going.
Right here.
Oh! The steel crunches on the feeble back of Holy Trent Acid. Oh my God. I'm gonna go out and have a cigarette.
One, two.
No, his foot's on the rope. This has gotta be pissing Tony off by now. If I was him, I'd just grab him by the face and squeeze it off until he gave up, because this is bullshit. He's using those ropes to his advantage, like a sneaky-ass brain uses everything else. There he goes, he's packing the boot.
Oh! One, two, no good.
No good.
And Holy Trent Acid, I believe, would fuck a hole in the wall if he had a chance.
He sure would fuck a hole in the wall, and he'd rather fuck a nun.
He'd rather fuck a man's face, obviously.
Trent Acid now...
He'll fuck anything.
Very much in control of the match. Tony, all but unconscious.
Holy shit. Tony's taking a beating. This man, Holy Trent Acid, I hate his guts. Oh, but nonetheless, he has the fortitude. He has the splititude. He has the turbuckleitude to remain in the match with the man from Louisville, Kentucky.
And
he's going back up to the top.
He has a higher power or a lower power on his side.
Whoa. Oh, it's not helping his face right now. Holy shit. That steel is relentless.
Watch out for Tony coming from the skies. And Tony.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. That right there will put any man out of his fucking miseries. One, two. Oh, that fucking rope again. That fucking rope. I'll tell you what, that's the second time Trent Acid has used that rope to his advantage, and fuck him for it.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If the rope wasn't right there, that might have been it for Trent Acid.
There's no question in my mind, 3D, that would have been it. If that, oh shit, that steel again to the face. Good thing Too Tough Tony is so drunk he don't feel pain no more. But if that rope wasn't there, yeah, two or three times now, he would have been done with.
Too Tough Tony hasn't been sober in 7 years.
Hell no, and he don't plan to be in another 17. What's going on here? Oh, Hurricane Frankenstein.
Whoa!
Throw a fucking chair.
A Franken-Tony off the top rope, crushing what's left of the steel chair.
Oh, shit, in the South Beach Diet referee.
And here comes the Tony driver. His face is right in Tony's anus.
Oh, the back of his balls and ass. Oh, shit, and there it
goes. That's got to be it for Trent Acid.
Get him the fuck away from them ropes, Tony. Get him away from them ropes, and you got it. What's he doing? He's pussyfooting.
A crucial mistake not going for the pin. Too Tough Tony needs a swig.
That's his problem. He's a fucking alcoholic. Instead of being concerned with the 1, 2, 3,
no!
He's concerned about a swig.
He's setting up for the meteor right.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh. Look above. Because here it comes.
No, see, I told you. He should have won for that fucking pin. He would have had him. Instead, he's concerned about the meteor.
Hey. That right there is the fires of hell.
He should be used to that.
Hey, I didn't come to Grand Rapids to get disrespected. I do not condone this devil worship, and I'm out of here.
Let me tell you something, 3D. There should only be one kind of fire that man's scared of, and that should be the fires of hell, but apparently I'm wrong.
He's obviously afraid of the fire that makes the smoky sausages on the end of Tony's fist.
That's right. They make a bubble and get crisp, so they're delicious to eat.
That was straight bullshit. Winner by count
He's
out, Too
it.
Tough Tony.
He's loving it. And I see one not so happy juggalo in the crowd because he was voting for Holy Trent Acid, but he did not win. I believe that was a no contest.
What a straight up asshole, Trent Acid. The match was a seesaw battle. Both of them pulling out, no stops, giving it all toward each other. But once Trent Acid saw the meteorite coming through the clouds and making its way toward his fucking face,
well,
he bailed.
Whatever the circumstance might be, 3D, there's only one word that I could possibly think of in the dictionary of what I like to call my head for Holy Trent Acid. And that one word is pussy. Yes, he's a fucking pussy. He's a piece of shit, fucking scaredy cat, pussy.
Well, he's scared of fire, perhaps because he knows fire is his impending future.
Maybe he got burnt by a pussy once, by a gonorrhea fire pussy. Who knows?
Who knows? Who cares? There's your winner by count out, Too Tough Tony.
Brothers and sisters of JCW, the time has come. The time has come for the Messiah to rise. But I warn you, my fellow Juggalo brethren, I did not come alone here to Kansas City, Missouri. I will be with the Holy Spirit. And together, we will go down that righteous path to finally do what we said we were going to do. That is to save all of you fans from sin and from the disgrace and filth that is JCW. Tonight, Trent Acid is on the way to be your next heavyweight champion. God bless you.
Question on everyone's mind is, what is Zach Gowen going to do after he wins the Battle Royal? Well, I'll let you know what I'm going to do. I'm going to get the fuck out of Dodge, because if I see one more goddamn juggalo, I'm going to kill myself.
Scumbags of JCW! You saw it last week, you saw me get fucked! That's exactly what happened. I was this close to getting that JCW belt back. And what do you retards do? You spit in my fucking face. You throw shit at me. Goddamn if you didn't throw a fucking trash can in the ring. And from now on, I'm not going to be underestimated by Corporal Robinson. I'm not going to be underestimated by you fucking juggalos. I ain't going to be underestimated by anybody. Tonight, the Battle Royal is Madman Pondo, and I'm going to get one more fucking chance at Corporal Robinson. And when I do, new JCW champion. Get the shit out of my fucking face.
Yeah, well, maybe you should worry about getting your fucking teeth fixed first, motherfucker.
Oh, ain't getting his face fixed.
Let's go take a commercial break. Nobody fucking moves. We'll be right back.
That's right, y'all. Tonight, whoever wins a battle royal gets a shot at the JCW World title. But first things fucking first. Pondo, Necro, you wanna jump my boy? You wanna jump my homie? That's straight. Me, Two Top Tony, wanna know if you two fags got the balls to show up next week. Cause what we're gonna do is sip on down with your fucking blood. So when we're done with you fags, you'll fear what you don't understand and hate what you can't conquer, bitches.
We're back with JCW Battle Royal action.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
This next match is a 10-man over-the-top rope Battle Royal.
Is it ever? Holy shit.
The winner will receive a World Championship title match with World Champion Corporal Robinson to take place 2 weeks from tonight. Introducing first!
The anticipation's killing me, 3D.
From the Vatican in South Philadelphia.
Oh, fuck.
Please welcome Holy Trent Acid.
3D, you know what time it is right now, don't you?
It's time to take a nap and let the dogs out.
That's right, go outside and polish the wheels on your old clunker.
It's time to go give mom a call.
I'm calling the promoters of JCW. I'm gonna have all those waters he's wasting taken out of his paycheck.
It's time to go paint the garage. Anything but fucking sit and watch this idiot take fucking 45 minutes to get his bitch ass between those fucking ropes.
What I like to do, 3D, I like to sit outside and... Whoa! He just got beat up by a bitch.
He was attacked.
I like to sit outside and watch the fucking grass grow myself.
Anything's better than watching this asshole walk around the ring saying prayers and blessing the juggalos who don't need to be blessed by this satanic fuck.
The only prayers he's saying is he's hoping a group of 10-year-olds will come and massage his kernel side. Get off that top rope, you fuck. Nobody likes you. Jeez.
And give that fucking Bible back to the Red Roof Inn, you fucker.
Introducing next from Kansas City, Missouri.
A localer. Whoa, listen to the pop for this man.
Please welcome Michael Strider.
That's right, Michael Strider. Now, not to be confused with Danny Spider.
Now, Danny Spider is not this man. This man is Michael Strider. He's been to the WWE. He's been to Wrestle Society X. And he's been all around the globe, Guido. But most importantly, he's been to JCW now.
Introducing next, from Lawrence, Kansas,
another local celebrity.
Please welcome Colin Starr.
Here he comes, 3D, Colin Starr.
This man hasn't been anywhere. He works at Irish McDuffie's Noodle Bar, about three blocks down the street from the venue here in Kansas City.
Also a part-time job at Shell Gas Station.
From Lawrence, Kansas, please welcome Tyler Clogged.
A fan favorite here, 3D, Tyler Clogged.
Tyler Clogged works at his mother's Dairy Queen. That's right, his mom co-owns a Dairy Queen with her step-husband, Frankie.
Very delicious Kit Kat blizzards, I might add.
Introducing next, from Kansas City, Missouri.
Holy shit, they're all from Missouri.
Please welcome Jeremy Whiteass.
There you go, the man himself, Jeremy Whiteass.
Now, Jeremy Whiteass hasn't been anywhere in wrestling either, only because he's got a sexual criminal record and he can't get hired farther than this promotion that runs in the building when we're not there.
From St. Joseph, Missouri, please welcome Craig Caveman.
That's right, and there he is, the House of Fire, Craig Caveman.
Craig Caveman from the caves beneath the venue.
You might have also seen him in your local Geico commercial.
From the realm of pain, please welcome former JCW World Champion, Madman.
This man needs no introduction. All you gotta do is look at that fucking pit bull face, and you know it's old Pondo himself wearing the sky blue thunder shorts.
Michigan, please welcome Zach Cowan.
And there he is, 3D, the man I like to call the one-legged moonwalker. That's right, he's got the move down so candidly and explicitly, he can moonwalk with one fucking leg.
Well, he's got no choice.
The tag team from Lubbock, Texas.
Ho, ho, ho.
Crystal Lake. Please welcome Leatherface and Jason.
Here they come.
Now this is what I've been waiting for, 3D.
Leatherface and Jason Voorhees. Take a look at these two killers, Guido!
Hey, straight from New Japan Wrestling, all the way abroad overseas, all the way to here in Juggalo Champion Shit Wrestling.
The whole ring clears out of the way for Leatherface, swinging that chainsaw like a four-foot dick.
That's right, he was dry fucking the air with his fucking chainsaw, and you notice the sparks is his syphilis.
Wow, what a dangerous duo! But the ugly face Pondo is not afraid of shit.
Well, of course not. He's been hit in the face several times with a chainsaw. Look at his face, you can tell.
He's going right for that world title opportunity. As we stated before, the winner of this battle royal will receive a shot at Corporal Robinson's belt in 2 weeks from tonight.
I gotta say something right quick, 3D. The majority of the men in this ring are on the same team. They're all from Kansas and Missouri and the surrounding tri-state area. So I think these men definitely have the advantage besides the fact that they're weak, feeble scrubs.
That doesn't make them on the same team because they're from the same area. Look at them battling each other because they're scared to get it on with anybody from JCW.
That's right. They're battling each other so that the real JCW men don't come over and punch them in the face with real potatoes.
Now here you see Pondo has a fucking headlock and is grinding the face of the caveman.
That's right. And I see Jeremy Whiteass walking around, no competition, He's waiting for everybody else to get wore down so he can walk in for the easy victory.
Strider making his way through competition. He is no stranger to brutal action, having seen talent being crushed before his eyes in Mexico and in Puerto Rico. This man, Strider, has watched wrestling everywhere.
Now, you might be sitting there focusing your attention on Danny Strider and Colin Starr and all them, but me, I'm keeping my eye on these two big, burly motherfucking serial killers, Jason Voorhees and fucking Leatherface, because I believe they're going to be the victorious men in this match, and perhaps we might see a handicap match for that JCW title. Oh, shit, that sounded like an M80 blew off under his nipples. But I was saying they might have to go 2-on-1 for that prestigious JCW title, 3D.
Look at Strider holding Leatherface and Pondo with an extremely weak-looking elbow. That's one thing I hate about Battle Royals. Everybody thinks nobody's watching them, so a lot of weak-looking feeble moves are dealted out.
Hey,
but not by Strider, as he smacked that dude's back 175%.
For real. I think Tiger Clogged is called Tiger Clogged because his puppy leg.
Oh, there it goes.
No, he has not touched the floor. He has not touched the floor. God damn it. But Tony Clogged, his fucking wig comes off in the shower and clogs the drain. Wow, look at that running ass kick to a fucking Danny Spivey's face.
Strider eliminated from the Battle Royal. Things are getting hot and heated already.
That's right, Tyler Clogged getting a face full of rope from Leatherface.
Who the fuck is that?
That's Tony Clogged.
Who cares?
He knows how to clog dance and river dance. Tony Clogged, stick to that shit because your wrestling skills are the same as a fucking retarded monkey.
Now we see Pondo trying to team up. Oh, he eliminates the cave boy.
That's right. Jimmy Whiteass went flying over that top rope with the severe strength of Madman Poncho.
The guy with the nice curly perm is still in the ring.
That's right. We call him Tyler Clogged.
We don't call him anything. Ow, he receives the pogo stick right to the gut.
3D now is down to 4 JCW, man.
Oh, there goes Leatherface. What kind of weak edge?
And gets the other scrub out. Now it's just JCW versus JCW, how it should be, because Corbin Robinson will be facing the victorious man from this match.
Holy Trent Acid still in there, that asshole bitch. Oh, Zach Gowan with an elbow to his chin.
And look at Pondo just sitting back, watching them deliver punishment to each other.
Typical tactics on Pondo's behalf. Sit back, let the real wrestlers take all the punishment, and then collect the victory. Oh, and Zach Gowan's still there. No,
perhaps if he would have had a second leg, he could have caught himself from falling. What's going on? Pondo's going to walk up behind and grab his hips.
And now Pondo's going to take advantage, probably going to sucker shot Trent Acid right out of that ring and steal this title shot victory.
That's how Pondo does it, sucker shots, rabbit punches, and pussy hole punches. But no, he waits for the turnaround like mano el mano and squares up. And he's begging for his life.
Look at that.
Fucking pussy.
Trent Acid bowing down to Pondo. What a dream match this is right here. What a dream match we're looking at. Madman Pondo and Holy Trent Acid, and now they're getting it
off. That was a total juke out. He acted like he was going to punch him. He stopped and really punched him with the tip of his penis.
Look at the fans in awe over this dream match situation that this Battle Royal has come down to. These two men, they would never be meeting in normal circumstances, but the world title shot has got them two going toe-to-toe. Now, Acid off the ropes, caught by Pondo, and right there.
Oh, who did that hurt? I think Trent Asshole. What I want to know, 3D, who the fuck is putting out the budget for all these chairs to use it for each other's nuggets?
Well, these chairs are actually just plastic, and they're very inexpensive.
So who's paying for them? Not me, goddamn. Whoa.
It came out of Mike Strider's paycheck.
Whoa, a very jiggy move on the part of Madman Pondo. I didn't think he had real wrestling talent in him. I thought he just knew how to brutalize, how to kill, and maim.
One thing I'll tell you, Guido, when it comes down to heel versus heel, the Juggalos always seem to side with Pondo in this situation.
And look how easily he throws it. Oh, no, he did not touch the floor, 3D. In order to lose this match, your feet must touch the floor after the top rope.
They may hate both of these bastards, but when it comes down to it, they favor Pondo over the holy asshole.
Well, that's right, because when he gets wet from sweating, you can see through those baby blues and see the outline of his dick.
Or his pussy, whatever he may have. Maybe he has both.
That's
He's a hermaphrodite, and that's why his face looks like a truck driver's ass. Who knows? But right now, he is in control, having his way, and now he's going to set up Trent Acid on the chair.
That's right, because he's going to the top rope for what I like to call the weakest wrestling move in history, but he's going for it nonetheless, 3D.
It don't even hurt.
It looks like it hurts. It crushes the ribs of all competitors.
It doesn't crush anything.
Pondo, quit taking your time, you fucking idiot. He's going to move if you just take your time and showboat. I told you, damn it.
Might have hurt Pondo's butt. Now, look at that. Get your fingers out of his asshole.
Holy shit, and it looks like Holy Trent Asshole is victorious in this match. I can't fucking believe it.
Holy Trent Acid, the winner!
And once again, he is winning. He's on a streak.
He has won himself a shot at Corporal Robinson's World Championship title.
What brings you here today, my son?
Father, I'm having these really... really evil thoughts. These thoughts, Father, are about this man. This man that tried to take my sight, that tried to take my career. Father, all I'm feeling is anger. All I'm feeling is pain. What I'm feeling is I really think I'm going to kill this man, Father.
Well, my son.
Not unless he kills you first.
You know, the Lord does not tolerate snitches. Let that be a lesson to you, you, and you. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Next match, one fall with a 42-minute time limit. In fucking introducing first, from the Vatican in South Philadelphia, weighing in at 42 stones, please welcome the asshole, Holy Trent Acid.
Now, I don't know how good your computer screens are, but why is it that my suit coat jackets always look like somebody's fucking using them as a nut rag, Greedo?
I don't know. It depends upon where you leave your suit jacket backstage, because Trent Acid is known to jack off 10 to 15 to 20 times within a four-hour period, 3D.
Well, that in fact is true, and I've also done some sportscast journaling investigation into the life of Trent Acid, if
correspondence.
You will. I went to South Philadelphia to study his background to find out more about the holy fucking asshole.
Well, that's exactly why I didn't go there, because I don't want to go to fucking prison, 3D. If you dig deep enough, you will go to prison, because there will be naked boys involved.
Well, I didn't go through his computer files or his briefcase, but in fact, I wanted to know what kind of education, what kind of schooling that man has. And it turns out that he did go to the School of Religion right behind Tony Luke's sub shop right there in South Philadelphia. And there he was trained in a 3-week course of religion to learn how to become a pastor, a deacon, a priest, and a preacher, a 4-in-1 course in 3 weeks, which costed him $14 for membership. Don't forget about the fine art, the very, very fine art of pedophiling and taking the hoods off people that throw that at him in the crowd and put them on and getting hit in the head with shit. By the way, he did flunk out of the 3-week course after only a week.
You fucking done?
Well, he's getting sick of getting hit in the head. Oh, great. Give him the fucking mic. Let him talk for 45 fucking minutes to an hour. Jesus loves America. Come on already, you fuck. He had the mic to his mouth, then put it back down. Come on, you greasy-headed fuck asshole.
Jesus fucking Christ, shut up.
Now there's a man of, finely religious words.
Well, perhaps that's why he got kicked out after 3 weeks, 3D.
After 1 week.
I'll have you know that this being the Sin City, that it was going to be a lot of hard work to spread God's word amongst you juggalos here tonight.
Coming from an asshole like you, fuck yeah it is.
Hey, I know you people ain't too bright, considering the fact you paint your faces like clowns.
I don't know what a clown is. Do you know what a clown is, 3D? Well, he gets his face painted with spit, so how bright can he be?
Hey, enough of this, enough of this. I'll leave right now, and you won't see me wrestle tonight.
Go back to your job of fucking painting hamburger buns with ketchup and mustard, motherfucker.
That's right, Eddie's Quickie Lube. That's where he works in South Philly, Eddie's Quickie Lube. You get a free oil change.
What the fuck is this?
Ed's Quick Lube.
You people are disgusting.
Where he lubes Ed's hole. Yes,
you know
his hole.
You're so in a good mood tonight, right? Hey, have you guys heard of a guy named Corporal Robinson? He's the champion of this place, right?
He's the world champion, damn it!
I'm here tonight for a reason.
To pedophile their children, you fuckhead. And to receive quarters embedded in your skull.
And it's not to be disrespected. You know what? You know what? Fine. I was going to come here and preach God's word, but you know what? You people are way too far gone. I'm not speaking anything to these people anymore. Just introduce my opponent.
Good. Hurry up and wrestle because your fucking hair's drying out.
That's right. We can see your ears through your long hair. You're not supposed to be able to see your ears through your long hair. You couldn't see John Lennon's hair, ears.
Opponents. From Transylvania in Grenoble, France.
Oh, great. Here's the savior of the day. What the fuck kind of music?
I got a feeling I'm going to be very happy.
Weighing in at 220 fucking 7 pounds.
Who cares what he weighs?
K.G. O'Doyle!
Yes! Here he is, my favorite wrestler in the world, and he's going to take down Trent Acid. And you notice, this week he does have the mask on.
He's got his mask back. He's back on track.
Now you don't know who the fuck he is again. Just when you thought you knew who he was, you were fucking wrong. This match is going to be fucking awesome.
Once again, as mysterious as can be.
Yes, and a heel again.
The secret is now untold once again.
You'll notice now he's got his mask back on. He calmed down a little bit too. He's not jumping around
Maybe he didn't hit the pipe full of crystal meth today.
Well, you know, Guido, damn it, when the mask is off, he's like a fish out of water. He can barely breathe, his legs move out of control, and his spine turns into jelly.
That's his epilepsy.
It can barely hold his big waggly body up.
That's clearly his epilepsy. He has epileptic patches on the inside of that mask, which make him very calm and very copacetic to work with. And he's trying to French kiss the referee, that fucking asshole.
The referee enjoyed it very much.
I think he did. He tickled his mustache. Come on, C.J. O'Doyle. Show this fuckhead what you're worth. Show him how you wear that mask and show him why the fuck you wear that mask and shove those size 18s up his ass.
Boy, if anything gets me pumped up and wild up, it's that ring music from Trent Acid.
Trent Acid showing his asshole to the ref to get probed and searched with the referee's thumb and pinky.
The referee considering doing it. Ooh, he touches the dirty back.
I don't know why. What's up with JCW and gay referees? And a gay wrestler named Trent, the human asshole, because he looks like the inside of an asshole when you spread it out and take a peek inside.
Well, you can see clearly on the back of Trent Acid that he enjoys sleeping underneath oily semi-trucks.
That's right, because he's a squatter. C.J. O'Doyle pumped. He's ready for this match. He's going to take that number one slot away from Trent Acid, and we might see that gold around C.J. O'Doyle's waist.
Las Vegas Juggalos getting behind KYO Jelly.
C.J. O'Doyle, goddammit. This man, don't diss him. Don't down him. Look at him. He's pulling up his knee pieces. He's ready for action. And what the fuck is this asshole Trent Acid doing? He's swinging his arms around like a stupid ring-tailed lemur.
Test of strength.
There's no doubt who's stronger.
Oh, no. Switch arms. Test of strength. Test of... Watch it, CJ.
Oh!
CJ, it's a trick. Oh!
He's very easily confused.
Ow. He's always easily confused. He's a fucking moron.
It's that mask. It's too tight for his head. It makes his brains a little bit too tight.
You're just jocking the fucking mask.
Yeah, I am jocking him because it makes him wrestle much better. But in cases where he gets confused, it confuses him extra hard because there's so much information going on inside that mask.
God damn it, Guido. Is the mask a benefit or is it the bone?
It depends upon what kind of fucking mood I'm in, 3D. Bottom line, right now it's not doing much for him. He's playing patty cakes with himself.
You're not going to get the Juggalos behind you, Acid, when they're clearly, all 1,500 of them are clearly behind C.J. O'Doyle.
And the worst place to beat, nope. Oh, look, he counters. He's awesome. What? Oh. Nope, not the C.J. O'Doyle, my friend. He's too smart for that shit.
O'Doyle climbing to the top rope and flying missile drop kick.
Right on the fucking button of Trent Asshole. Look at him. He's alive. He's pumped. He can barely walk because his feet are too big for his body.
He's on fire.
Fuck yeah. Look at him. Oh, he's going.
Up,
he's going
up, to the top. Out. Oh.
What the fuck was that?
He kicked a piece of garbage out of the ring.
Well, it had to get out somehow.
Watch out. Over
Sunny
the top.
Sunny side up.
One, two, no.
Why'd he let him go? The knees, he didn't even touch the mask. Oh, and the balls. He went for the stomach. And I'll tell you what, C.J. O'Doyle actually has a mask for his balls, too.
That's right.
That is just as tight as his head mask.
His balls wear a mask. And
whoa,
he cannot be kicked in his balls during a mask because I have further sportscast journalist knowledge.
Well, go ahead and kick it, 3D.
C.J. O'Doyle tucks his balls into a mask and then firmly tucks his ball mask into his anus where they're safely guarded. They cannot be kicked, swiped, damaged, or punched during his athletic matches.
That's right, and his nuts never smell like shit because the protective mask is covering him, in fact. And he also has a mask for the head of his dick.
You won't even see a dick lump. Well, you will see a dick lump, but you will not see a ball lump when looking at his extremely tight spandex.
That's
all you will see is a pamper bump from the pampers he's forced to wear due to his medical condition.
You might think he doesn't have balls, but he does. That his mask up and tucked into his asshole. And what at Trent Asshole, speaking of assholes, he's toying with them right now, and he's not going to get away with showboating around C.J. O'Doyle like you just seen right there. The big comeback and all of reversal.
Look, I hate to burst your bubble, Guido, but you can get away with anything around C.J. O'Doyle. Any fucking thing you want.
I'll tell you what, 3D. Oh, my God, he almost took the fucking
You can
head
even
off.
Kick him in his marble head, head on, if you want. He won't even see it coming, even if he's watching your foot ascend right toward his face. He won't think twice to duck.
Hey, I won't be surprised, and within 6 months, if you don't see a C.J. O'Doyle wrestling action figure on the shelves of Toys R Us, 3D, because I'll be the first one to buy it, and I know him personally. I'll get it autographed and eBay it for $1 million cool dollars. Here it comes. Oh, good thing he don't got a fucking mask on his chest tucked up his asshole, because that wouldn't have hurt. But he got a bare chest at that time, and that fucking hurt from here.
Perhaps his nipples wear tiny little masks as well.
No, that's clearly his tassels that he puts on his nipples for when he strips in Dallas.
Back into the ring goes O'Doyle and his extra large skis.
I'm just waiting for Trent Asshole to get hit in the head with something. Like he does almost every match, he comes back bleeding from getting hit in the head with some shit. Oh, counter by CJO Freshness.
1 week away, West Side Wars. 1 week away, Trent Acid locks his devil's horns up with Corporal Robinson in the big rematch.
Now let's hope for that match that Trent Acid actually gives it his all. He don't bust out with some acid shit in a holy water bottle that clearly, oh, look at that sidewalk slam. That clearly wasn't holy water. There was some kind of devilish form of acid from Trent Acid, if I don't say so myself, 3D.
Trent Acid spits acid. He pisses acid. His blood flows with the devil's liquid, which is acid.
I think he might have wrapped this match up. Oh, he didn't pin him. That's right. You can't pin C.J. O'Doyle. C.J. O'Doyle's like, don't pin me because I'll kick out. Don't even try it. So he got up and blessed him instead.
Guido, will C.J. O'Doyle be at West Side Wars?
He'll be in the main event against Hulk Hogan, 3D. In a steel cage match.
Maybe in his sleep the night before he'll be in that match. But he will be at West Side War supporting in the crowd.
And he will be at the hot dog stand selling hot
dogs. Oh, that's disgusting.
Oh, my God. He just dry fucked his dick with his dick.
He dry fucked his nose with his anus.
That's right. Dicks were rubbing and noses were on assholes.
That
what
was
kind
horrible.
Of shit?
I'd like to see him do that to Corporal Robinson. It won't be that fucking easy, Trent.
3D, what are we selling here? Wrestling or gay porn? I'm getting confused up in here with this fucking asshole in the ring, Trent Acid. He just dry fucked C.J. O'Doyle's dick with his dick and dry fucked his nose with his asshole.
He's got the acid again. Whoa. Here comes Corp. That's here right. comes Corp. Yes. Oh. Yes.
And let me tell you something. Those punches are not ginger in the least bit.
Hell no, they're not. Into the ropes. Look at that. Sit down slam. Yes.
The crowd. Super kick. Up the rockers. Holy shit.
This place has exploded.
Get the fuck out of the ring, you cocksucker. Then get out the hard way. By compliments of the champion, Corporal Robinson.
Corporal Robinson refusing to let anybody else be blinded by that acid from that asshole.
That's right. Hey, he didn't have his acid. Corp seen an open opportunity, and he took care of fucking business. He came in there and fucked his ass up.
Wow. It's going down at West Side Wars. It's going down between those two.
Trent Acid doesn't even know what the fuck hit him. He got to the top of the ramp and passed the fuck out. Look at him. He's out like a baby woman monkey bitch.
Fucking believable.
In the glory.
West Side Wars 1 week away. It's going down.
Tonight, in the City of Angels, marks the end of my mission. As I start the new revolution in JCW, past month, I have raised hell in order to bring the good here. And Corporal Robinson, tonight, through your sacrifice, they will see me cast the biggest sinner of them all. Tonight,
It's going down in a big way. JCW brings you the main event of West Side Wars.
This is the main event. Introducing first.
Happy mug on that, boy. Gotta love you, 3D.
From the Vatican in South Philadelphia, weighing in at 42 stones, please welcome the suspected pedophile. Whoop.
I didn't know King Kong Bundy was around.
Holy Trent Acid!
So let's hope this is a trimmed down version, so I don't have any potatoes to bake right now. I don't have any corn to boil.
You don't have any roast beef in the slow cooker?
No, I don't. I gotta sit here and watch this fuckhead walk around the ring for 40 minutes.
No sun tea marinating on the deck, huh?
No sorry, Bob. No fucking lemons to squeeze.
Well, how about a little trim job editing? Because we could do without the 55-plus minute intro as he slowly walks his way around the ring, blessing, christening, and sometimes kissing the younger gentleman ringside.
Or perhaps get a call girl and get a little bit of trim.
Well, the one thing you can say is, well, they say it never rains in Southern California, but it's certainly raining pennies, used condoms, and spit all over the likes of Holy Trent Acid tonight in Long Beach.
Not to mention 9-volt batteries.
And everything else the Juggalos are pelting toward Holy Trent Acid.
Ooh, he comes back with water. Water hurts.
This is the one you've been waiting for. Corporal Robinson, the world heavyweight champion, finally gets his chance at revenge against the man, the saint, or the sinner that tried to blind our world champion. This is what it boils down to.
Oh, fuck. The mic? I hope somebody hits him in the face with something. Come on, cock warmer.
Busting out of the shirt.
Now, is that any way to treat your next heavyweight champion?
Was that any way to treat Curly from the Three Stooges, the referee? Jeez.
Now, I know you're all happy to see me tonight. You know, the good Lord has brought me to what this is called, the City of Angels.
Actually, that'd be L.A. We're in Long Beach.
For a long speech.
Oh, yes. Get him, Curly.
Words of advice from the Juggalos.
Very good words of advice.
Well, if he'd heed and listen to the words of the Juggalos, it might stop raining indoors.
The problem is, I haven't seen any angels since I got here. All I've seen is a bunch of pimps, hoes, and dead rock stars.
Hoes? Penny hoes? I wasn't aware that Trent Asshole was Shucky Ducky.
Yes, yes, yes. We will all be one family under the Lord after tonight when I win the belt.
Yep, perhaps the belt you bought from the truck stop.
The good Lord has asked me to come out and try to touch you people.
I'll bet he did.
Try to cleanse your sins.
Touching people is Trent Acid.
Of the male persuasion.
Young altar boys.
If you can all shut the fuck up.
Whoa.
Hey.
There's some words from a holy man.
Perhaps his game is full of
holes. I'd like you all to bow your heads. as I say a prayer for you, because God knows you need it.
I feel bad for you, 3D, having to sit in there and look at that crap.
At least I got those sweet-ass shorts on. They let your nuts air out pretty good.
Bow your head to...
Always good for a headshot, that guy. Not only a headshot getting hit in the head, but giving headshots.
That's right. I wouldn't know about that, but Curly might. Something in the eye?
Yes, tears. He's crying.
Lord, please pray. Please bring your power and cleanse their sins. For these poor deviants and drug addicts do not know what they do.
Drug addicts, huh?
Please, Lord, save them from this filth that is JCW. And please show these fucking idiots the right way, because I can't fucking stand them. Amen. And God bless you. And God bless you.
The mouth found this fucking guy. Whoa.
A right hand from sweet old 3D.
There you go. You still got it in you. The absolutely. Old tugboat still pumping, huh?
Absolutely. A sweet-ass right hand knocking the altar boy right on his bitch phony ass.
Well, Curly did a good job of breaking it up because he was going to poke you in
flip
the eyes.
Flip me off, motherfucker. I'll break your motherfucking neck. That's right.
Oh, and a good shit-talking game to boot.
People are ready for some fucking wrestling already.
You should have kicked his ass.
I did. One punch and he was down for the count. Knocked his fucking boots loose.
Jesus Christ, Trent asshole. What the fuck?
Take off your bathrobe and let's get to some wrestling action. This is the main event already. Even Curly's starting to get pissed.
He's going to get in trouble by Mo when he gets back to the dressing room. He's going to get slapped in the face.
Curly was poured into that shirt and those jeans.
That's right. He's a giant water balloon.
Ready to pop all over Trent Acid's ass if he doesn't get started. Quit humping the ropes, you fag. It's pretty brave stepping up on that top rope
and
in that hurricane.
His opponents.
Here comes the court
from Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Yes, he followed the ref.
Weighing in at 239 pounds, JCW World Champion, Corporal Robinson.
And it's about fucking time. There he is, the pride of JCW.
Watch the house come alive as the world champion makes his way down to the ring. This is what Westside Wars is all about, Guido.
That's right, and he must have been sitting in that gorilla position for a good 2.5 hours waiting for that fucking cock reamer in the ring to get the fuck off the mic.
Finally, world championship material enters the ring, and we're about to see a main event take place.
We're about to see a slaughter take place as Court plummets the face of this hippie reverend.
Hopefully you're right. I hope you're right. You hope you're right. The 1,500 juggalos in Long Beach hope you're right. But look at that dirty, snaky rat. Reaching under the ropes, reaching under the ring, garbage picking for junk.
And there goes our champion, the epitome of health, smoking a square right in the middle of the ring.
That's right. Ready to fire one up for JCW and fire one up right up the ass of Holy Trent Acid.
And if you'll notice, the referee has an ass on the front of his pants.
As well as the back. He's got about 4 or 5 asses. Right there, a sneaky fucking shot. Catching Corp off guard, delivering the boots, right to Corp's neck. This match is underway. The bell has sounded, and the main event has started. Who's it gonna be, Guido? Is it gonna be Acid, or is it gonna be Robinson? This, oh!
Oh my God,
fuck in the face of the champion.
Jesus Christ.
This match is about vengeance. This match is about revenge. This is a grudge match, if there ever was one.
Now, I need to know something right quick, Greedy. What is up with the heels in JCW Pearl Harboring the faces all the time?
That happens all over wrestling. All the time. It's a typical signature bad guy move. I thought you knew.
Oh, I only watch JCW. I never watch any other wrestling.
Well, if you want to see wrestling, watch what happens to Trent Acid as soon as Corp gets on his feet and gets shit going his way. Bang!
Oh! Nice face plant into the metal chair into the corner. And let me tell you something about Corporal Robinson. He's the real deal. He is burly. He is tough. He is from Wisconsin, where they don't fucking play. He is bred off cheese.
That's right. Mean ass cheese. That's born right. And raised on a cheese farm. Bang! There's some cheese shit for your face, Trent Acid.
Now Trent Acid's face looks like holy Swiss cheese.
That's right. Corporal Robinson has all Juggalos on their feet in the palm of his hands. They are ready for blood. This is world championship material taking place. Not enough yet, but you never know. Trent might be asleep. He might be high on drugs. He might be high on fucking sex. He might be high on sin. We don't know. The man is pure evil. Whoa.
One thing you gotta realize about Corp, he does not take his championship matches lightly. Every match he goes out there, he fights for that JCW belt. Bam! Break his bitch-ass motherfucking face out to the crowd. I hope those Juggalos kick his ass out there. They are too.
Into the fucking piranhas goes Trent Acid. Getting stomped, punched, pinched, stabbed, and sometimes
finger
squeezed.
Banged.
Finger banged. Yes.
Through his pants, popping a hole into his underwear.
That's right, you are, Guido.
And Corporal Robinson does not take the coveted belt lightly unless he gets his face smashed into that metal pole. That shit hurts.
Those turnbuckles are solid steel.
I think I might smell juice.
And they're no stranger to the head of Corporal Robinson. I'm guaranteeing you Corp is juicing as we speak.
Well, what you gotta understand is the forehead of Corp looks like wet tissue paper, so if it gets hit properly, it's gonna bleed.
The forehead of Corporal Robinson looks like he's been scratching it with a barbed wire bat. And now, Corp's gonna race to his feet, bloodied, but ready for more battle. The fisticuffs ringing off the forehead of Corporal Robinson. Some angry fucking Juggalo being toted out. This is personal for the Juggalos. This means more than just something they're there to cheer or boo for. They are wrapped up in this excitement. They want to see Trent Acid beheaded.
Let me tell you something, 3D. Corporal Robinson, not just a JCW champion, not just a wrestler. Corporal Robinson is a certified brawler. He's not scared to get his fist bloody from the face of other assholes.
No, not afraid of bloodying up. Not afraid of getting dirty. Not afraid of trading knucks with any motherfucker. When he's not wrestling, he's in a tough man contest. When he's not in a tough man contest, he's in a shoot fight. This man, also a cage fighter. Also a real renowned guerrilla wrestler. And let it be known, this man also plays euchre.
That's right. And he's very good at cribbage. And let me tell you something else. When he's not in his cage fights, he goes bar hopping. He don't go bar hopping like me and you to get drunk. He goes bar hopping to beat up bar patrons.
That's right. Bar patrons and old men.
That's right. He hits them on the face with bar stools.
Now, reversal. Acid into the ropes. No. Acid on top of his game tonight, it would seem. Reversals back and forth.
Oh!
Whip DDT. Acid on top of that ass. No.
You called that right. Trent Acid perhaps did actually train for this match instead of just hanging out with kindergartner boys.
Yes, it would appear Trent Acid is on top of his game. His speed is up to par tonight.
And what is this foreign object? Oh, he just got hit in the head with a glass. What is this foreign object hanging from his wrist? I think he's going to use it for no good.
Everything is going down in this match. Foreign objects, legal objects, objects recognizable right there.
And a brain buster. That does nothing good for the neck of Corp. But he don't give a fuck because his neck is made out of steel and rubber.
It's a good thing Corporal's brain is actually located in his elbow. And Corporal's head is actually solid.
That's right, solid bone. Oh, brain buster number two. And look, oh, maybe he hit his elbow that time. He might have hurt his brain.
Slightly stunned, you would appear. Yes. Slightly stunned.
And why the fuck is Trent Acid wearing a tie? That's so he can, when he jacks off, he ties the tie around his neck, and right when he bought the nuts, he makes himself pass out.
Possibly. But one thing I know for sure, he claims to be a man of the Lord. I would guess he's more a man of Lucifer.
I'm going to go ahead and say he's a man of the Lord, but he calls little kids Lord.
Corporal Robinson blocking the suplex attempt. And now he's going for one, on second attempt. This time reverse. Corporal Robinson with a brain buster. Planting Trent's head onto the seat of the chair.
Holy shit. Let me tell you something. Here in JCW 2. Oh, I thought he had it. Here in JCW, these fucking chairs aren't those hokey plastic piece of shit chairs that you might go and like put out at the beach and watch the fireworks. No, these are hard metal adamantium steel chairs that you get hit in the fucking face with, you're liable to break your whole fucking face open.
What kind of chairs?
Adamantium steel, asshole.
That's that hard shit.
That's right. Like Trent Acid's cock when he looks at a gay porn.
Like Trent Acid's dick on a playground. And now, ascending to the top rope, Trent Acid caught Corp, cold-blooded, and launches.
Oh, my goodness.
Sailing faceplant. And Trent right on top.
Two.
No. Corp, at the last minute, kicks out of that one.
It's moves like that that makes JCW what it is. The most hardcore wrestling on this fucking planet or any other planet in this bitch-ass universe.
And you see the blood all over the white shirt of Holy Trent Acid. No, he has not been wrestling a bowl of spaghetti. That is the blood from the head of Corporal Robinson.
Or perhaps from his anus.
We're not quite sure. Corporal bleeding in 7 different areas as we speak. Trent Acid has now set up 2 chairs. What has he got in store for the wounded champion?
This man, Trent Acid.
Whoa.
Oh, shit.
Corp now retaliating, fighting back. Into the ropes goes Acid. Whoa! Sit down powerbomb through both chairs.
Now, you want to talk about a backfire? 1, 2, champion? Oh, shit. So close.
That was extremely close. But the champion could not put away the challenger.
This Trent Acid is a conniving motherfucker. And I'll tell you what, he gets every reversal that he deserves because he's pulling those chairs out to no stops and, bad for him, to no fucking avail.
I do not know if Robinson expected this much out of Trent Acid here at West.
Oh, the referee's down. Curly just did the Curly Shuffle.
And Robinson with the boot camp. That's got to be it.
One, two, three. Curly, get up your fat ass and ring the bell, you motherfucker.
The referee is completely fucking knocked the fuck out asleep. And Corp landed the boot camp, but the referee is passed out, dreaming about hostesses filled with macaroni and cheese.
That's right. He likes his Twinkies. He sucks the filling out and puts macaroni and cheese in the middle of it with extra Thai spice.
And then eats that.
And then plugs it.
Corp now going for a table. If that wasn't enough, if the boot camp wasn't enough, perhaps this table will do the trick. But he must remember to wake the fucking referee up first.
He's got some random ninja helping him too.
Trent Acid.
Now Trent Acid is trying to wake the ref up to get, what's his face? The Corp, the champ is qualified. But what he has to realize, you cannot win that title by being disqualified. You must win by submission or 1-2-3 pin. This stupid fucking shit fuck, God damn it. I don't know what to fucking do. Get up, referee.
This referee still out unconscious. Acid in a daze. And now, Corporal Robinson setting up that fucking 12-foot-long wooden table.
Yes, that wooden table is as long as a speedboat.
And now, Corporal Robinson is setting a fucking beaten and bruised Trent Acid on the table and ascending to the top rope.
Wake the referee the fuck up, Corp.
Corporal Robinson now on the top rope. Sails across the ring.
Oh, my goodness. Not even a leg drop. His ass went right through the face of Holy Trent Asshole. Now that's why we know his name is Asshole, because he just got a face full of corpse asshole.
A second 3-count by Corporal Robinson. But once again, the referee is still unconscious.
He's on the wrong side. Yeah, smack him in his head. Say, get up, you fucking piece of shit. I already beat him twice. What are you doing? You're down on the ground, dry humping the canvas.
Now Corp is finally waking up, fucking Curly. Get the fuck up. How many times do I gotta pin this asshole?
You know what? He's not even fucking Curly. He's the gay one Curly Joe that always goes yapple dapples.
Now Corp going for a third pin attempt.
One, two, and
the fuck?
Because he waited fucking 20 hours, this piece of shit referee. I want to schedule a match, me versus fucking Curly Joe, in a yapple dapple match where I'm going to punch him in the face, one punch knockout, fuck him.
Unfucking believable. Corp had Trent Acid not once but twice down for a 10 count, and fucking Curly fucking Joe is now asleep again, it would seem.
Great, now what's this cocksucker up to? He's up to no good. That's not your belt. Put it down, you fuckhead.
Holy Trent Acid has the world title in his hands. The referee's sleeping in the background.
He's taking a nap. He's overweight. Sometimes he gets excited. His blood pressure gets high, and he passes out.
When he has to take random naps.
Yes, the Juggalos are not letting Trent Acid through. They're like, asshole.
I told you. This match is personal to the Juggalos. They will not assist Trent Acid in any way. And now Trent Acid with the belt. Whoa, Corp's going for the boot. Oh, shit.
Goodness.
A second shot with the gold right upside the skull of the world champion. And now Curly Joe's counting. Three. No, it can't be. It can't be.
3D. What I just witnessed was called nothing but bull fucking shit.
It can't be!
Son of a bitch. And look, he beats the ref up for helping him. What kind of asshole does that?
There's a new world's champion in JCW.
No, there's a new world's fucking cheating cocksucker is what there is.
I cannot believe it. Trent Acid is the new JCW champion after not one, but two vicious belt shots to the dome of Corporal Robinson. Finally, fucking Curly Joe wakes up and makes the fucking 3-count while Corp is pinned.
Corporal Robinson beat him 3 to 4 times this match, but that fat fuck Curly Joe is taking a nap until he comes over for the 3-count for his favorite gay friend.
Unfucking believable. I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. The Juggalos don't know what to say. There's a hush, a stunned hush over the crowd.
I know what to say. Fuck you, Trent Acid. That's what I have to say.
Jesus. I'm literally speechless at this point, Guido.
I'm going home, and I'm going to go cry. Son of a bitch.
There's a stunned hush among the Juggalos. They can't really believe what just happened. Corporal Robinson has just lost JCW world title.
Good. Get a hot one in the back of the neck, you fucking fool.
All because of pudgy poo-poo the referee.
That's right. That's all he does is go to Chinese store and order the poo-poo platter.
Too many poo-poo platters. He couldn't fucking make the count. Look at that fucking asshole. I cannot believe he is our new world champion. Holy Trent Acid.
Brady, I never thought I'd say this, but I love you. You're my best friend.
Well, thank you.
I don't know what that has to do with this match, but fuck. Damn, I'm speechless.
There he goes, the new world champion.
There he goes, out the curtain and straight to hell.
We'll have to see how this plays out on the upcoming weeks of Slam TV, but there you see Corporal Robinson down, but surely not out.
And how come wrestlers always go,
he just lost the world title, and look at this.
If Corporal don't punch that fucking referee,
a standing ovation from the Juggalos in the house. They know Corp has just been cheated. They know that's the real champion. Look at that, a standing ovation. Round of applause for Corp. They know that he is...